Hello guys, welcome back. My name is Sushil Singh and this is continuation of SQL Server interview questions and answers. In this session, I am going to discuss how we can apply join in a single cell. So let's move to our question. This is our question. We have two input tables. First is item master and second is variant master. In item master, we have two columns. First is item code and second is variant ID. In variant ID, you can see you don't have normalized data. So you have comma separated values in variant ID. In variant master, we have normalized data and it has only two columns. First is variant ID and second is variant description. In our output, we want to put join between variant ID of item master and variant ID of variant master. And then we want to display our output. In our output, we can see simply we have to pick the values for item code and then we will pick the value for variant description from variant master. So here we can see variant ID 1. So variant ID 1, variant description is for variant ID 1 is A. So we have to display A as it is. And second is 2. So value for 2 is B. So B will be displayed as it is. So for item code 2, variant ID values is 3, 4. So 3 is C and 4 is D. So for 2, C, D will be our output. Now let's move to SQL Server Management Studio, where I have already created these tables. So our first table is item master and it has same metadata as I have displayed in slide. So this metadata and this metadata both are same. And I have created second table as well, which is variant master, and we can see it has the same metadata. And before going forward, I would like to explain about the char index, how char index work. So char index will return the position of any character within a string. So our input string is Sushil, Singh, and we want get the position of comma. So we can simply execute and we can see it will return the first occurrence of this comma. When we are going to execute, then we can see it will return 8. So we can count from S. So we can see comma is in 8th position. So it will return 8 inside the query. So you can see this is our query by which we can get our output. So this is our output. And before going forward, I would like to select item master. So in item master, first of all, I wanna split variant ID 1 and then 2. We want split these IDs in separate column and these ID would be separated by using this comma. So here inside this CTE, I have already write the code by which we can see it will return our desired output. So here you can see in our first left value from this comma, we are going to use the left function, and inside the left function, we want pick the value from this variant ID column, and then how many characters we want? We want pick only those characters which is before this comma. So comma will be written by using this char index as I have explained earlier. So it will return the exact position where comma exists. Then I have to subtract minus 1 by this char index value because it will return value where comma exists. So we want value before comma. So it will return the value for left join. And second, I am going to use substring. So in this substring, we are going to select value from this variant ID column and we want to pick the value where this comma will exist. It will return our first occurrence of this comma and we want pick the value just after this comma. So we have to add 1 from this char index and then how many characters we want, then we can calculate the total length of this cell and then we have to subtract the comma value. So we can simply execute our length function, then we can subtract comma. then we will get our result. So this is our result. We can execute and we can see this is our desired output. So we have to simply put join between this table with our variant master table, and then we are going to combine the output for these two tables. So here you can see I'm going to use left join between this CTE and this variant master table on the behalf of, first of all, left join column, and second for right join column. So first we'll return the values for before this comma, and second we'll return after the comma. So once I'm going to execute, then we can see it will return our desired output as we have seen here. So both outputs are same. You can use the query and we can get the result. I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel for many more videos. If you need, these scripts will available on my Facebook page. You can copy from there. Thank you so much for watching this video.